sing right to you. Wanna sing right to you. Cause you're teaching me what it means to lean. Teaching me what it means to lean. Oh, you're teaching me what it means to lean. Teaching me what it means to lean. To lean. One unshakable thing. Oh, you're teaching me what it means to lean. Teaching me what it means to lean. On what is eternal, on what is unshakable, on what really matters. Teaching me to lean. This is a conversation for two. Conversation for two. Speak and you respond. You speak and I respond. Each day, each morning and night. Speak and you respond. You speak and I respond. Each day is a new day with you. You teach me what it means to lean. As you teach me what it looks like to lean not on my own understanding, to lean not on yesterday's understanding. Fresh revelation each day, fresh revelation each day. This is what you promise. This is what is accessible to those who believe, those who are children. We have access. We have access to fresh revelation each day. Fresh revelation each day. Fresh revelation each day. In a conversation with you, in this conversation for two. Give fresh revelation each day. Fresh revelation each day. In this conversation with you, in this conversation for two, I hear your voice. I hear your voice. Fresh revelation each day. Fresh revelation each day. In a conversation with you, in this conversation for two, I hear. hear your voice, hear your voice, I hear your voice, hear your voice. Calling out my name. Calling out my name. Saying, where are you? Where are you? Where are you? You will never leave, and your love sustaining me. Before I even knew what love was, you've brought me here to rest and given me space to breathe. So I'll stay still until it sinks in. Every burden is lifted, every chain is broken, in the loving arms of our Father. Just run to Him free, run to Him free, rid of every burden, rid of every weight, rid of every burden, rid of every weight. He's saying, no pressure, no pressure. I'm lifting that pressure, taking on from the world. No pressure, no pressure. There is freedom, there is lightness, and you will never leave. Your sustaining me. Before I even knew what love was, you've brought me space to breathe. Thank you, Father. So I'll stay still until it sinks in. I will lean back in the loving arms of a beautiful Father. Breathe deep and know that He is good. He's a love like no other. I will lean back loving arms of a beautiful Father. Oh, breathe deep and know that He is good. He's a love like no other. Still until it always love me the same. Always love me the same. To the fullest. To the fullest. To the overflow. He'll always love me the same. Always love me the same. This is what changes me. What changes me. This is what changes me. What changes me. Only your love has the power to transform my heart. Only your love. Tender and kind, compassionate and true, patient and merciful, is love, love, love. Never self-seeking, never boasting, never mistrusting, oh. Your love is kind, your love is true. Your love is righteous, your love is just. Your love knows what gives life. Your love revives, your love revives. Your love resuscitates all the dead parts of my heart. Your love revives, your love revives. Oh, it brings revival, starting with my heart. Your love revives, your love revives, your love revives, bringing new life, your love revives, your love revives, your love revives, every part of me, every part of us. Your love revives, your love revives, your love revives, your love revives. New life is possible with you, only possible with you. New life is possible with you. Revival. Your love revives, your love. heart it woke up. And I'm not afraid to see your face, 'cause I am alive and you care. I knew that you would come. And call me out of my grave. Oh, you came. I knew that you would come. Put a new song in my mouth. You put praises on my lips. Put a new song in my mouth. Put praises on my lips. And I'll breathe deep and know that He is good. He's a love like no other. Thank you. Kicking out every regret, kicking out every fear, kicking out every unkind thought. Let only love remain, let only love remain. Just what we've thought of it. We want to know the fullness of the Father's heart, and not just what we've made up, not just what we've assumed. Teach us afresh. Teach us, speak to us afresh, that we may know it's from you. Give us the Father's heart. Give us the Father's heart. Give us the Father's. Give us the Father's heart. Give us the Father's heart. Give us the Father's heart. Without it. Oh, we need the Father's heart. We're desperate for. Father's. to know. Slow down, take time, breathe in, he said. He revealed what's to come. The thoughts in his mind, always higher than mine. He'll reveal all to come. Take courage, my heart, and stay steadfast, my soul. He's in the waiting. He's in the waiting. Hold on to your hope as your triumph unfolds. He's never failing. He's never failed. Sing praise, my soul. Find strength in joy. Let his words lead you on. Do not forget his great faithfulness. He'll finish all he's begun. So take courage, my heart, and stay steadfast, my soul. He's in the waiting. He's in the waiting. Hold on to your hope as your triumph unfolds. He's never failing. He's never failing. Oh, take courage, my heart. Stay steadfast, my soul. He's in the waiting. He's in the waiting. Hold on to your hope as your triumph unfolds. He's never failing. He's never failing. You who hold the stars, who call them each by name, will surely your promise to me that I will rise in your victory. You who hold, and you who hold the stars, who call them each by name, will show. take courage, my heart, and stay steadfast, my soul. He's in the waiting. He's in the waiting. And hold on to your hope. And as your triumph unfolds, he's never failing. He's never failing. Watching my triumph unfold by the one who holds the stars, who calls them each by name, who will surely your promise to me that I will rise in your victory. Thank you. shut us out. Nothing can shut it down. Nothing can shut us out. Nothing can shut it down. Nothing can shut us out. Nothing can shut us out. As hope arises, hope arises. Oh, yeah. You will get your glory. 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 Glory, yeah. Nothing can shut it down. Cause nothing can shut us out. Nothing can shut it down. Oh, as faith arises, hope arises, faith arises, hope arises. To the rhythm of your heart makes us one, makes us one. So we'll march on, singing our anthem. March on, singing our anthem. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Lord, and marching to the rhythm of your heart makes us one, makes us one. Marching to the rhythm of your heart makes us one, makes us one. Marching to the rhythm of your heart makes us one, makes us one. Marching to the rhythm of your heart makes us one, makes us one. Marching to the rhythm of your heart makes us one, makes us one. Oh. So we will march on, we will march on, singing that your kingdom, that your will.
Lord, we thank you so much for this time this morning. It is truly the cry of our hearts to march to the rhythm of your heart, to feel rightly, to speak rightly, to think rightly, to have your perspective, to know your will, and to actively be a part of seeing it done here on this earth. So wash us with your presence again today, God. We thank you that you have been moving already in our midst, Lord, and we ask for an even greater increase of your presence, Holy Spirit. Come, we invite you here to come even deeper, even closer, even nearer. Your nearness is our victory. We find our victory in you today, God. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. We are now going into a time of praying and singing from the Word of God. This morning, we will be reading Revelation 22, verses 1 through 21. I encourage you to find it in your Bible and join us as we meditate, sing, and pray through these verses. Revelation 22, verses 1 to 5. Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life, bright as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb. Through the middle of the street of the city, also on either side of the river, the tree of life, with its 12 kinds of fruit, yielding its fruit each month. The leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. No longer will there be anything accursed, but the throne of God and of the Lamb will be in it, and his servants will worship him. They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads. And night will be no more. They will need no light of lamp or sun, for the Lord God will be their light, and they will reign forever and ever. Almighty God, we marvel and are amazed at your word today and the picture that it paints for us. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place, the tabernacle of the Most High. This river is your presence, and it flows from your throne and through all that is yours. It is clear and bright and has no mixture, for it is pure. Almighty God, we need this today. There's so much mixture in your church and in your people. Minister to us with your water that nourishes and reveal this mixture in us. Just as the 12 trees yield fruit each month, bring fruit out of the seasons that we are in right now. We ask God that in our season, whether it's hard or filled with joy, that you would bring your glory into our season. You would truly be glorified through us in all of the circumstances of our lives. We know, Lord, that you are with us and that you are working to mature our faith during this time. We truly are your people. And you truly are our light. So today, God, we look to you, and your word says that you make us radiant. And so we ask, God, that you would open our eyes and help us to see your face, shining like the sun, dazzling with newness. Amaze us today once again with who you are.
Flow
planted by the streams of living water. I want to be like a tree planted by the streams of living water.
I want to be fed and nourished by the streams of living water. Nourish us today, God.
Living water. I want to be like a tree planted by the stream of living water, bearing good fruit, bearing good fruit. I want to be like a tree, so plant me deeper in you, deeper in you, deeper in you. Let my roots go down, 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 deep, deeper in you,
deeper, God. Deeper, deeper,
deeper in you. Let me deeper in you, oh, deeper, deeper, deeper. I want to be like a tree planted by the streams of living water. Oh, I want to be like a tree planted by the streams of living water. I want to be unmovable and unshakable, so let my roots go down deep. Unmovable and unshakable in you. I want to be unmovable and unshakable, so let my roots go down deep. Unmovable and unshakable in you.
Revelation 22, verses 6 to 9. And he said to me, "These words are trustworthy and true. And the Lord, the God of the spirits of the prophets, has sent his angel to show his servants what must soon take place. And behold, I am coming soon. Blessed is the one who keeps the words of the prophecy of this book. I, John, am the one who heard and saw these things. And when I heard and saw them, I fell down to worship at the feet of the angel who showed them to me. But he said to me, 'You must not do that. I am a fellow servant with you and your brothers, the prophets, and with those who keep the words of this book. Worship God.'" Jesus, these words are trustworthy and true. It wasn't just enough for the angel to tell John. You also wanted to let us know their importance. You are coming suddenly, Jesus. We pray for the grace to be ready for that day. You want us to keep this prophecy, for prophecy leads us to trust and obey you. Help us to live out our faith and to apply your truth to the way that we live, for that is the safest place we can find ourselves to be. Lord, I also want to thank you for this example of seeing John so overwhelmed in heavenly presence and seeing how he was corrected to see things rightly. There was no shame or harshness. And we ask that you do the same for us when we are overwhelmed. Guide us and bring us into greater understanding of the things we can't understand. John didn't understand. And so he was given the understanding he missed. And we pray for the same thing. What is overwhelming for us is never overwhelming for you. And you love leading us and guiding us into greater understanding. Mark us today with this truth, that there's nothing that's going to come our way that's going to overwhelm you. Though it may overwhelm us, that nothing ever overwhelms you. Anchor us in you today, God, in new ways. Reminding us again of who you are and who you're not. Reminding us again of who we are and who we're not. So that we can see you rightly and understand things rightly. Do it today, Lord. Do it today.
Mark us with your truth, God, with your understanding. Let us see you rightly. Mark us with your truth, God, with your understanding. Let us see you rightly.
Mark us with your truth, Lord.
Mark us with your truth, God, with your understanding, and let us see you rightly.
We need revelation. We need to see you rightly, God.
Mark us with your truth, God, with your understanding, and let us see you rightly.
Release fresh revelation, Almighty God.
Let the truth shape us and mold us, shape our understanding. Let truth be the guideline, let truth be the measuring stick, let truth be the thing that holds us down. Shape us, come mold us, come shape us, come shape us. You are the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus, come mold us, come shape us. For you are the way, the truth, and the life. Come mold us, come shape us into your likeness. 'Cause you are the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus, come shape us, come mold us into
shape us with your,
your
truth,
likeness.
Lord.
You are the way, the truth, and the life.
May we not shape. truth, Jesus, but be shaped by your truth.
Come shape us, come mold us into your likeness. Oh, you are the way, the truth, and the life.
Give us an appetite for your truth,
Jesus,
that we would hunger.
Let us hunger after you. Seek the truth out. Let us not tire, but let us seek the truth out. Let us seek the truth out till the very end, till it comes to pass. Oh, let us seek the truth.
Let us
out.
Seek your truth.
Let us seek you, Jesus.
Give us grace.
Till it comes to pass. Oh, till you come back.
Let it be a fire inside
let
of us,
Let us
God.
Seek the truth out. Let us seek you, Jesus. Till it comes to pass. Till you come back. Let us seek the truth out. Let us seek you, Jesus. Till it comes to pass. Until you come back. Till you come back. Mark us with your truth, God, with your understanding. Let us see you arriving. Mark us with your truth, God, with your understanding. Let us see you arriving.
Revelation 22, verses 10 to 15. And he said to me, do not seal up the words of the prophecy of this book, for the time is near. Let the evildoer still do evil, and the filthy still be filthy, and the righteous still do right, and the holy still be holy. Behold, I am coming soon, bringing my recompense with me, to repay each one for what he has done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes so that they may have the right to the tree of life, and that they may enter the city by the gates. Outside are the dogs and sorcerers and the sexually immoral and murderers and idolaters and everyone who loves and practices falsehood. Almighty God, in the book of Daniel, we read about a time you gave a vision and then instructed Daniel to seal it up, because the vision wouldn't take place for a long time. But here in Revelation, there's an urgency on your words. Help us to get this today in the deep places of where we are in our spirits. You are coming soon. And when you come, what has been done in the dark will be exposed, and your justice will come as well. There will be a complete end to all human trafficking, abuse of every sort and way, exploitation, torture, murder, and every scheme of the devil to separate you from the ones you dearly love. Hallelujah! We long for this day. You are the Alpha and the Omega, Lord over all. And we thank you for reserving the tree of life for those who have put their faith in you, Jesus, and have lived out their faith. Thank you for making the way for us to enter heaven through a relationship with you. was opened on your side and extends to our side. We thank you for the picture of the cross in this gate. At this time, in Revelation 22, you will restore us to full and complete health through the tree of life and by your power. And you will introduce us to greater intimacy than we have ever known is possible. Let this awaken a new hunger inside of us, Almighty God, to fight for the things that you fight for our hearts to break for the things that your heart breaks for, and for us not to give up, for the time has not come yet. We pray for mass revival. We pray for your light to shatter the darkness all over this earth, God. We pray that your grace and your mercy would flow. We pray that you would limit the number of those who will be kept outside and cast outside. We pray, God, that we would see you and worship you in spirit and in truth. We would know you fully and be known fully by you. Yes, God, that's our prayer.
Long for a time that is near. We long for a time that is near. When we see your justice and righteousness. Your justice and righteousness.
Your justice will roll down.
Justice and righteousness.
Your righteousness will be seen by all.
Oh, you'll bring your recompense with you when you come. When you come. Oh, we long for. Justice, when you bring your justice fully, completely, leaving nothing unmended, leaving nothing unattended to, the fullness of your righteousness. Oh, we want the fullness of your righteousness. Want the fullness of your righteousness. Oh God, my vindicator. God, you're my defender. God, you are the one who fights for justice. Oh, so I don't have to take matters into my own hands. We don't have to defend ourselves.
You are preparing everything, even right now.
Because you're the God of justice. You're the God who fights on my behalf. Oh, you're the God who brings recompense. And even now before you come, even now before you come, you're doing it. You're bringing kingdom, bringing justice and righteousness. Your kindness brings us back to you, back to repent. We may enter in. so freely given, such a prize for our redemption. Heaven's gates swing wide, and by faith we enter in.
Revelation 22, verses 16 to 21. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify to you about these things for the churches. I am the root and the descendant of David, the bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, come. And let the one who hears say, come. And let the one who is thirsty come. Let the one who desires take the water of life without price. I warn everyone who hears the words of the prophecy of this book. If anyone adds to them, God will add to him the plagues described in this book. And if anyone takes away from the words of the book of this prophecy, God will take away his share in the tree of life and in the holy city, which are described in this book. He who testifies to these things says, surely I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with you all. Amen. Jesus, every time you declare your name, your kingship and your power comes and touches us. Touch us today in a fresh way. You see us right now. You know us intimately. And you are not just a king, but you're my king. Today we take our place as part of your bride and say, come. We invite you. Let this invitation become a cry and deep longing in us. You invite us as well to come and receive fully from you and your waters of living water. Your mercy and your grace flow so freely, yet we are reminded again that there will be consequences for those who try to change your words or add to them. Search us today and show us where we have misunderstood you or misrepresented your heart in any way. For ignorance at that time will not be an excuse. And so we ask, God, that you would penetrate our minds, penetrate everything that we know, that we would take this warning seriously, but not fearfully. We don't want fear to push out your love in our lives. So God, we ask for you to guide us into all truth in these different areas of our lives. Guide us into greater understanding and the fullness of knowing you and who you are. Wake us up today, God, for you will come suddenly, and we want to live our lives in a way that is pleasing to you. You know what gives life, and we cling to old structures. You know the new things that you want to do. And we hold to the rules that have made us feel safe and comforted. Do something new in us today, God. Blow our minds with your power, with your dreams, with your visions, with your expectations and your plans for us. for our church, for this world. That's our prayer.
Search my heart and know me, God. Search me out and teach me where I need to rely. Show me where I've gotten it wrong, where I've misunderstood. In your kindness, your gentleness, your love, you will come and show me, come and teach me, come and recalibrate. Give me the fear of the Lord, the fear of the Lord, that you are who you say you are, and you'll do what you say you'll do. Give me the fear of the Lord. Give me the fear of the Lord. Of the one who was and is to come. Write your word on. All my weariness to you. Give all my doubts and misunderstandings to you. So come and renew my heart. Come and renew my heart. Wake me up to praise again, to wait again. To do good again. Let it all be free.
God, we thank you so much for your word and how precious it is. There's so much more freedom in you than we know. There's so much more beauty and love and truth and wisdom and depth than we know. And God, I pray that as we read your word, that it would draw us to the heart of the author, and that's you. That we would not pull verses out of context, that all of that would just be wiped away, God, and that new and fresh understanding would be given to us, God, as we sit at your feet to learn, that you would guide us and lead us. Thank you for this day, God, and what you've deposited in each one of us today. We pray that you would bring abiding fruit from this morning. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Now we will be going into a time of intercession through prayer topics. This morning, we will be praying for North Korea and South Korea. On April 27th, there will be an inter-Korean summit where the presidents of both North Korea and South Korea will be meeting face-to-face. We want to cover this historic meeting in prayer today. Many things are discussed when national leaders come together, and there are requests made. We need to pray for the results of this next summit to be the results God wants for these two nations. Please come into agreement with me as I pray, along with the prayer points on the screen. And then raise intercession with your own voice as the Spirit leads you through each topic. Heavenly Father, we ask you to pour out your grace upon the days leading up to the summit. We pray for you to control the media and the news stories that will be released and coming out. Use them to build hope and lead people into right thinking and away from prejudice and wrong thinking. You are making history at this time, and you are working powerfully behind the scenes. We trust you. Lord, bind all fear and paranoia associated with this upcoming summit, and settle the hearts of the people. Shut down the negative and destructive voices at this time. Lord, we pray for your peace to rest upon every detail and for your grace to make sure that the leaders meet. We declare that no knee-jerk reactions, no last-minute cancellations will be able to happen. And we declare safety, health, and favor over the staff who is busy preparing everything on both sides. We pray for you to lead the support teams who are gathering all the information on the topics that are on your heart. Lead them. Highlight those topics, God, so that those are the things that are addressed. Do what only you can do and stir up new favor and healthy interest at this time. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for working in the hearts of President Moon and Kim Jong-un to meet at this time. Thank you for making that a desire that was mutual. They're seeking greater cooperation, and they're seeking for less tension to exist between us. In the midst of this, we pray that they will be seeking you, seeking your wisdom, seeking your guidance, your insight. You are the Lord, and there is no other. Lead them at this time to take refuge in you as they prepare. We cancel all assignments of the enemy against these two leaders, and we pray that you will send your angels right now to hinder every attack against them in Jesus' name. Lord, bind all manipulation, evil agenda, and acts of intimidation from their interaction. Make these things impossible during their time together. We pray blessings over them physically, mentally, spiritually, and emotionally. We pray for open and willing hearts as they sit down at the table. Guide their every emotion, word, and thought. Silence every voice that is not for good and that is not of you. We declare never heard of before type cooperation and healthy inter-Korean future partnership as a result of this meeting. Let us pray. Almighty God, we lift up specifically the topics that will be discussed at the summit. The nuclear situation and other topics will be discussed and are a very high priority. But we pray for the South Korean citizens who are currently being detained to be set free through this summit. This has been a topic that has long been ignored. This has been a topic that the North Korean side has not even been willing to have a conversation about. And we pray that all of that changes at the summit. We pray for your shalom, Almighty God, to rest upon Ko Hyun Seo, Che Chun Kil, Kim Kuk Hye, and Kim Jong-wook, and every other South Korean citizen currently being detained. No longer will the requests for their return be ignored. We speak freedom. We speak release. We declare that the time is now. We declare justice flowing down over all of the detained foreign nationals, and that you will bring their full release. This is a common bargaining chip, and we know that is true. And we pray that all of these men, all of these people will be returned to their families, returned to their communities and their friends. We pray that you would strengthen these families and friends who have been waiting for so long and give them a fresh deposit of hope as the summit appears. We pray for there to be favor on this request and for Kim Jong-un to easily agree to these requests and for it to be done so swiftly within a day. We pray, God, that what has not been possible in the past would be. You have heard every prayer. You have heard every declaration. And we declare that now is the time. Now is the time to pray these things. Almighty God, we declare that now is the time for those who have also been abducted, the South Korean citizens who have been abducted and forcefully taken to North Korea, for them to be returned as well. Just as the persistent widow was told to keep asking and reminding the unjust judge for her justice, we do the same today on behalf of those South Korean citizens who have been abducted. The time is now for each person to be acknowledged, shown as valuable, and returned to their homes and to their home country. We declare an end to North Korean silence on this issue, and we declare open and honest communication at this upcoming summit. We pray for acknowledgement and apologies. We pray for South Korean citizens who have been abducted, and that they would be allowed to leave. God, we thank you that South Korea has already financially prepared for their return and set aside money through the government, just awaiting their return to help them settle back into society. This is such a beautiful gift, God. And we pray that they would be able to step in and receive that fully. We bind the tactic of bullying and and the spoiled child mentality of taking what you want, regardless of how other people feel. And we release true compassion and desire for cooperation and unity. Change things in the spirit, making this no longer possible. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you that we had the privilege of praying for the things on your heart and lifting them up. Freedom is on your heart. Restoration for those who are hurting. You long to set the captives free, and we stand in agreement with you today. Whether it's mentally captive, emotionally captive, physically captive, we thank you that you are Lord of all. You are the Alpha and the Omega. And we thank you that you are omnipotent and you are omnipresent. Nothing gets past you. And we thank you that you are in and over all things having to do with this summit. We pray that you would be glorified. We pray that your will would be done. And we pray that your kingdom would continue to grow and increase on the earth, in North Korea and here in South Korea as well. We fully trust, God, that you're bringing about amazing things to the summit. We love you, Lord. I thank you ahead of time for the powerful testimonies and stories, the freedom that will come, the changes that will come. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your love that will be demonstrated through the summit. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thanks for joining us this morning. Hope that you are blessed. We will have another watch tomorrow evening. However, it will be different than usual. We will not be having it here on the fifth floor, but we'll be doing